السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1900 with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jalla. Today we focus on the 5th of Rajab. It was on the 5th of Rajab, the year 92 after Hijrah, corresponding to 20th April 711, the Gregorian calendar, Tariq bin Ziyad. You know Gibraltar is named after him, Jabal Tariq. Nevertheless, he departs by boat from Tangiers, and that is Moroccan side and so forth, to Gibraltar to conquer Andalusia, and that is Muslim Spain. When they reached there with their boats, they burned their boats and they made dua, "Ya Allah, let us establish Islam here, or otherwise we will perish here." Lo and behold, Allah Jalla Wala accepted their duas. For 780 plus years, Islam and Muslims thrived there in the land of Andalusia, and that is Spain. You look at Cordova, you look at all these areas there, and you will find great, great architecture, masajid, darulums, and so forth. And remember that Portugal also a part of it. So all this happened, remember this, but today the Ummah has forgotten. These were the youngsters who diced with death. He was only 22 years old at that time. And go and see the indelible legacy they left behind. Thereafter we go and see on the 5th of Rajab, the year 948 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 25th of October, the year 1541. The Ottoman army achieved one of its greatest victories against Spain and the Christians of Europe. And this was, they attacked, the enemies attacked Algeria with a massive army and force. And the Muslims killed more than 20,000 of the enemy soldiers and dispatched them to the hellfire. Their corpses of the soldiers were strewn around the shores for many kilometers. People would just see the enemy's bodies and corpses. The Ottomans also captured more than 130 ships of the enemy, and that is of the Spanish and of the army of Europe, the Christians. This victory is considered as one of the greatest victories in the history of the Algeria and the Ottomans. So imagine that, to kill 20,000 enemy soldiers, take 130 ships. After this battle, none of the crusader forces, the Salbiyin, ever thought of occupying Algeria, and this for almost three centuries, and then except in the year 1830. So it shows, when the Muslims put their heart and mind and they have quwwat imani, they don't place their trust, you must remember, on the arms and ammunition only, like the Arab states and Muslim countries today, but first they place their trust in Almighty Allah. They have that iman. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu idha laqitum fiatan faz, when you meet the enemy forces, remain steadfast. Wazkurullaha kathira, and you remember Almighty Allah abundantly, profusely. La'allakum tuflihun, then you will be successful. Now you be honest today, which army can we show that will go and attack the enemies, which will take over their ships and so forth? Not one, because our iman also has become so weak. So every day in history, there is such inspiration, motivation. So read history to inspire and motivate us for the future. Read history so that we do not commit the mistakes of the past in the future. And read history, because our Islamic Muslim history is written in black and red. The black ink of the ulama-i Rabbani, the ulama-i Haqqani, the true ulama of the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, and the red blood of our martyrs. Mustafa rahmatul alamin sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man lam yashkurin nas lam yashkurillah." A person who does not thank humanity, in reality, has not thanked Almighty Allah. I must thank my colleague, my brother, Mona Ahmed Dokrat, Hafidahullah, his family, his wife, children, parents, that it was his initiative, and today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah, we reached this milestone of 1900. May Almighty Allah accept it. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta samiul alim. I also place on record my thanks to Hafiz Muhammad Basa, mashallah, for keeping our website updated with all this nasiha. May Almighty Allah accept us all for his deen. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Salamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.